Allahu Akbar.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi ta'ala wa barakatuh. Alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen. Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah wa liyus salihin. Ashhadu anna muhammadan abdullahi wa rasuluhu al-ameen. Wa rahmatuhu lil alameen. Sallallahu alayhi wa ala alihi wa ashabihi ajma'in. Amma ba'd, assalamu alaikum again wa rahmatullahi ta'ala. Let me begin first by thanking my dear brothers in ICNA and MAS for inviting me. It's almost 10 years since I last came to ICNA-MAS convention. And alhamdulillah, it is kind of a joy for me, inshallah, to be with you in the convention. Now, the second, whenever I am asked to speak about Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam, I get very worried for a number of reasons. One, طبعاً, the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام, speaking about him is not an easy job. Although anyone think can speak about Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم, but we have millions of books, millions of scholars, conferences, and so many things that have been written about Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم. So we cannot just reduce them in 20 minutes or 18 minutes and do justice to it. But let me tell you, few points I'm going to say to them, they might guide you about what it came to my mind. First, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told us in the Quran, شَرَعَ لَكُم مِّنَ الدِّينِ مَا وَصَّى بِهِ نُوحٍ وَالَّذِي أَوْحَيْنَا إِلَيْكَ وَمَا وَصَّيْنَا بِهِ إِبْرَاهِيمَ وَمُوسَى وَعِيسَى أَنْ أَقِيمُوا الدِّينَ وَلَا تَتَفَرَّقُوا فِيهِ. Literally, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us that what he gave us, the sharia that people here question, actually the same sharia that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave it to Nuh and Ibrahim and Musa and Isa. And all of this is to establish the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam basically came and put this together. This is why we Muslims, I said this before many times, imagine yourself now living during the time of Musa alayhi salam. What would you be? You'll be a follower of Musa alayhi salam. No questions asked. If you lived during the time of Isa alayhi salam, surely you will be among his hawariyin. Those of us who, inshallah, commit themselves. Now, when Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam came, actually, he put all this together for us. And one of the things that Allah also told Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam, that he commanded him, actually, command. He said to him, فَلِذَٰلِكَ فَدْعُوا وَاسْتَقِمْ كَمَا أُمِرْتُ وَقُلْ آمَنْتُ بِمَا أَنْزَلَ اللَّهُ مِنْ كِتَابٍ وَأُمِرْتُ لِأَعْدِلَ بَيْنَكُمْ اللَّهُ رَبُّنَا وَرَبُّكُمْ لَنَا أَعْمَالُنَا وَلَكُمْ أَعْمَالُكُمْ اللَّهُ يَجْمَعُ بَيْنَنَا وَإِلَيْهِ الْمَصِيرُ. I want you to go over these verses with me. Anyone, this is for any person. Allah commands his messenger Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam with all the assurances that he gave him, that Allah sent the book for him with absolute truth. أنزل عليك كتاب بالحق والميزان. Yet he told him, فلذلك, he gave him a long list of things, and he said to him, because of this, أدعو, call people. But stay steadfast as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commanded you. When you talk to others, look at how Islam comes. He says, واستغم كما أمرت. وقل, tell them, آمنت بما أنزل الله. I believe in the Torah, I believe in the Zabur, I believe in the Injil. أُمِرْتُ لِأَعْدِلَ بَيْنَكُمْ. Even to do justice among these people. Why? He said, Allahu Rabbuna wa Rabbukum. Christian, Jews, name it. They claim that Allah is their Lord. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, tell them, yes, He is our Lord and your Lord. طيب. Where we differ is, how do we express ourselves in relation to showing of love or consideration or obedience to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So Allah gave us this and gave them this, and he says, Allahu Rabbuna wa Rabbukum. Lana a'maluna wa lakum a'malukum. Now, people can live. I was very actually moved by this idea that Imam Majid mentioned about the neighborhood and love your neighbors. Actually, this verse says that. It says you have a neighbor, a co-worker, somebody with you in the school, and so on. You don't have to fight with them. Allah is their Lord, Allah is our Lord. You express the way you deal with Allah the way you want. We express it. And the difference where? He said, Allahu yajma'u baynana. then leave Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the akhirah. He will gather all of us and then he will be the judge for us. That's the first point. The second point that I wanted to mention to you, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, Muhammadur Rasulullah. Muhammad is a messenger of Allah. وَالَّذِينَ مَعَهُ, that's all of us, أَشِدَّاءُ عَلَى الْكُفَّارِ رُحَمَاءُ بَيْنَهُمْ تَرَاهُمْ رُكَّعًا سُجَّدًا. This description that Allah gave to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in relation to us basically tells us exactly what Allah says to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that you are going to take care of this because this is the ummah of Muhammad that can be, as Allah said, a witness over all the other people that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for us. During the time of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, they said some groups, some say some Jews, mostly and some Christians, came and questioned Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. They said to him, Ya Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, you claim you came from the same God that sent Musa and Isa and Ibrahim and these people. Now, why then do we see things that differ from us? There are certain things that are lawful here, they are not lawful here. There are certain things we can do, you cannot do, and so on. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala answered them this way. For those who actually want to be sincere with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and most of them did, they came back to Allah and they became Muslims. He said, those who followed Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, الَّذِينَ يَتَّبِعُونَ, and see the description he gave to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, الرسول, النبي, الأمي. There is no messenger that came from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with these three descriptions. A prophet and a messenger at the same time. And we know, we tell our students all the time that all messengers are prophets, but not all prophets are messengers. Because a messenger has to be a prophet with a message from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, but a prophet does not necessarily have to be a messenger. So Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was both. He was Nabi, and Allah addressed him as this, Ya ayyuhan Nabi, Ya ayyuhan Nabi, Ya ayyuhan Nabi. And he addressed him as his Rasul. But above all, he was an unlettered person. This is why, by the way, some of our scholars say, why don't we have a tafsir of the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam of the Quran? We don't, right? We don't have a like tafsir ibn Kathir, tafsir al-Qurtubi, tafsir al-Tabari, tafsir al-Zamakhshari, tafsir al-Hakim. Name all these tafazir, tafim al-Quran, zilab, all of these. But we don't have a tafsir of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Why? Because Allah sent the Prophet with a text, and that's the text is the Quran. And it would have been limited or frozen sometime in history if the Prophet made any interpretation then, because many things came later on. Those of us who read Surah Sad, for instance, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, miraculously chose the chapter titled him as a letter in the Quran, Sad. And Surah Sad speaks about the Quran. Sad wal Quran is dhikr, bali alladhina kafaru fi izzatin wa shiqaq. The last verse in Surah Sad, because of the time, and I know we already race with the time, Allah said, wala ta'lamunna naba'ahu ba'da heen. So two questions came to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. They said, Ya Muhammad, Faris, what is it that you are going to know after some time? In one of the reports, they said the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam paused and he said, I long for my brothers. They didn't come out. So one of the companions said, Ya Rasulullah, aren't you your brothers? He said, no. بَلْ أَنْتُمْ أَصْحَابِي. You are my companions. And a companion is the person who is the person. We didn't see Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. We didn't talk to Rasulullah directly. We didn't eat with him. We didn't pray behind him. He said to them this, that you are with me, you interact with me. My brothers will come generations after you. Generations, we hope and pray Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala include all of us in that group of people. He said these people will see what Allah told them about the Quran. So for those people then, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, الَّذِينَ يَتَّبِعُونَ الرَّسُولَ النَّبِيَّ الْأُمِّيِّ الَّذِي يَجِدُونَهُ مَكْتُوبًا عِنْدَهُمْ, because it is in their books. And now it's clearly coming out for many people who write about Islam, even non-Muslims now, who are sincere, they will say to you that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the Torah and the Injil, even as it is now, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala clearly mentioned Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. الَّذِي يَجِدُونَهُ مَكْتُوبًا عِنْدَهُمْ فِي التَّوْرَاةِ وَالْإِنْجِيلِ. Look at the authority Allah gave to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to be the prophet of all. He said, يَأْمُرْهُمْ بِالْمَعْرُوفِ. There isn't any good that Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam didn't tell us about it. And there is no one, not even the worst of enemies, will say Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam came with anything other than good. Ma'roof. يأمرهم بالمعروف ينهاهم عن المنكر and to forbid them from anything that is evil, that is bad. The same thing. Now, on top of this, يأمرهم بالمعروف وينهاهم عن المنكر ويحل لهم الطيبات. The Prophet was given the authority by Allah to decree what is halal and what is haram. Goes further. He says, يحل لهم الطيبات ويضع عنهم إصرهم والأغلال التي كانت عليهم. In the previous books, in the previous religions, Allah put a lot of burdens on people. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam was sent as a prophet of all to lift all of this and actually to ease out the religion and the deen for the people that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave them for this. Now, the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam also, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us that he sent him to whom? Kaffatan linnas. That, alhamdulillah, even in history, that you can see the history from the time of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam until today. Every prophecy, even the Prophet, let in the Quran, said it, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala fulfilled it. Let me give you one. Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, the hadith that's long, most of you know it, that it'd be an era of prophethood, تَكُونُ نُبُوَّةً مَا شَاءَ اللَّهُ لَهَا أَن تَكُونُ ثُمَّ يَرْفَعُهَا اللَّهُ إِذَا شَاءَ. It'd be an era of prophethood and then it'd be ceased. And then he said, وَأَكُونُ آخِرَ الْأَنْبِيَاءِ. And it'll be the last prophet. لا نبي ولا رسول بعد. There will be no prophet or no messenger after me. ولكن, but he said, كذابون. There are people who did. None of them stood the test of history. All the people who came and claimed to be prophet, they added nothing. There is absolutely nothing to add to what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has said in the Quran. Because Allah said to the Prophet alayhi salatu wa salam, وَنَزَّلْنَا إِلَيْكَ الْكِتَابَ تِبْيَانًا لِكُلِّ شَيْءٍ وَهُدًى وَرَحْمَةً وبشرى للمسلمين. So this has been fulfilled. The guidance is completed. The glad tidings is completed. The rahmah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is completed for humanity at large. One of the things that I wanted to mention because of this, there is a young man, actually he's a Jew. His name is Bruce Feiler. Some of you might have heard the name. He wrote a book. He became very famous about it. If you go to YouTube, you go to just Google it, you'll find Bruce Feiler. I had a chance to meet with him actually in a presentation that he made in a church when I was in Kansas City. This young man went and visited Jerusalem, visited these places, came back and wrote a book. He became very famous about it. And the book is titled Walking the Bible. You know, in our schools in the early days, we used to give songs to children. I was dreaming, went to Mecca, saw the Kaaba, drank Zamzam. I remember when I took my children to Umrah, every time you go to a place because they know this song, they say, saw the Kaaba, saw Zamzam, touched the black stone, like in a song form. This young man said he wants to go and see every place where the Bible mentions, the Old Testament. And he wrote this book, he came back, he called it Walking the Bible. But he was surprised, he says, when he went there and found in Jerusalem, Muslims, Christians, and Jews. He came with another project, and that's the book that we discussed with him, and the book was titled Abraham, A Journey to a Triple Heritage. What he said basically is that all these confusions and conflicts and fights about religion can be resolved because we all belong to Ibrahim alayhi salam. He felt that Prophet Ibrahim alayhi salam will be the unifying factor for all of these religions. And he wrote this beautiful book, what is called A Journey to a Triple Heritage. That brought me actually to this verse that I just mentioned to you, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, شَرَعَ لَكُم مِّنَ الدِّينِ مَا وَصَّى فِيهِ نُوحٌ وَالَّذِي أَوْحَيْنَا إِلَيْكَ. And what we gave to Ibrahim alayhi salam and the rest of the prophets that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made in sequence for them. Now, I have a few minutes left, but let me say this. I remember when we discussed this book with him, we were invited, they invited me to represent Muslims and one Christian, that he made the major presentation about his book, and then we wanted to verify the information that he has. Like Muslims will say, this is right. I remember I went through the book almost word for word, and then we had the discussion about it. One thing that attracted my attention is this. Every time he mentions something about Islam, he quotes Ibrahim alayhi salam. And I was surprised. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us in the Quran And by the way, the Prophet used to refer to himself. You know, many times Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used to say, "Ana da'watu Abi Ibrahim." I came as an answer to a prayer my father Ibrahim alayhi salam made to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And we all know when Ibrahim and Ismail were rebuilding the Kaaba, they made this dua, "Rabbana taqabbal minna innaka anta as-sami'u al-alim, Rabbana waj'alna muslimin lak." But among the prayers, because of the time, they said, "Rabbana wab'ath fihim rasulan minhum." Oh Allah, send those people in Mecca, a messenger from among themselves, يَتْلُوا عَلَيْهِمْ آيَاتِكَ وَيُعَلِّمُهُمُ الْكِتَابَ وَالْحِكْمَ وَيُزَكِّيهِمْ. Then Allah answered this prayer in the Quran by saying, لَقَدْ مَنَّ اللَّهُ عَلَى الْمُؤْمِنِينَ. Indeed, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has favored the believers. By the way, he didn't say al-Muslimin. He said the believers, anyone who believes in Allah, anyone who believes in God, by sending them this messenger, Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, again, yatlu alayhim ayatihi, but he changed from yu'allimuhu al-kitab to yuzakkihim, wa yu'allimuhu al-kitab wa al-hikmah, wa in kanu min qablu fi dhalalin mubin. And from there on, if you trace even the history of religion, trace the history of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, trace even the history of the Jews and the Christians, you will come to one conclusion, that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam will remain to be the reference that everybody will go back to, inshallah. And we will be, as the brothers were telling you all along, that we as Muslims should really take that lead, because we have something in our hands. We know the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. One of the things that the Prophet alayhi salatu wa sallam mentioned, he said on the day of when he was reading this verse, that he will be a witness over everyone, and this used to bother him because Allah burdened him with that, and we will be witnesses over other people. He said, on the day of judgment, many people will come and deny that even Allah sent them a messenger. Yani people like Nuh alayhi salam, you know, the longest ever prophet. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, لَبِثَ فِي قَوْمِهِ خَمْسِينَ مِنْ أَلْفَ سَنَةً إِلَّا خَمْسِينَ عَامًا. Actually, this is the time he spent among people. So most of the scholars say Nuh was more than 950. But Allah said, مَا آمَنَ مَعَهُ إِلَّا قَلِيلٌ. Very few people. So he said, some people from this prophet who stayed that long. And by the way, people used to live long. One of the things that I want to leave with you just in this, they said a woman, a mother, lost a son during the time of Nuh alayhi salam. And this son was 300 years of age. So the woman really grieved so much. And they brought her to Nuh alayhi salam to comfort her. So he said to her, Ya Ummah, ma'am, you have to be very grateful to Allah. Allah gave you 300 years to enjoy this son. And Ummah, and actually the Prophet said that he meant our Ummah, will come, the average age is between 60 and 70. You know, the Prophet said, A'maru Ummati. So the woman said, really? Only 60 years to 70? Ayabnoon, do they build homes? Because she thought this is too short even for a person to build a house to live in it, compared to the long time. Despite all of this, the Prophet والسلام, tells us, people will deny that even Allah sent them a messenger like Nuh. Take all the prophets. From time of Nuh, Ibrahim, Musa, Isa, Yunus, all the prophets that Allah at least mentioned them in the Quran for us by name, and those, each and every one of them, we know what they came with, we know what their message will be, the best reference for them if we take our deen seriously and actually really engage in this. The two things that I want to leave with you, there's a beautiful book called Hada Rasulullah. I mentioned this in ICNA conference. This book, actually 30 Muslim scholars worldwide gathered the best of what Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said and put it in this book. And I think there is a website about it. And if you go there, find anything that you read about Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and you'll find nothing but confirmed that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is the prophet and messenger of all. Aqulu qawli hadha, astaghfirullah li wa lakum, assalamu alaykum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.